Let's see back propagation in neural network with an example. Okay, now this is a neural network. In this is the input layer, this is the hidden layer, and this is the output layer. Okay, and these two are the biases. Okay, now from input layer goes to the hidden layer, then from this hidden layer the output of hidden layer goes to output layer, and from this we will get the output, actual output, and we will back propagate the error calculated here to the input layer back, so that we will update these weights. Okay, now we will see how this overall process going on with an example. Let's see now how we will calculate the output at hidden layer using this one. H1 equal to x1 w1 plus x2 w2 into b. This is a formula. Okay, now we will apply a activation function to get the output at hidden layer or at output layer at every node, okay, in middle of the network. So as the input passes from this one, input layer to hidden layer, let's see this one x1 here, x1 into w1, x2 into w2, here we will get the output, this one h1. Now we will apply the activation function on it. One of the activation function is sigmoid, 1 by 1 plus e power minus x. If you want to know about activation function, there is another video, you can check it out of me. Okay, after applying this activation function on h1, this is how we will get output of h1 equal to 1 by 1 plus e power minus h1. This is output we will get. Let's see with an example. Okay, consider an example. These are the values, these are input values x1 x2, and these are the weights. We have seen this network, no, this network, in this these weights we have randomly initialized the weight and bias of the network. Okay, this can be any weights and bias, can be any values, you can give any values. Okay, but these are the input values, and our target values are these one, that is output. We should get this output. Okay, now we will calculate. Now first we will do forward pass. That is, see, this is our network, no? So we'll pass these values like this to get the output. So forward pass. Now we are calculating it h1. That is, we are calculating it this one h1. That is x1 w1 x2 w2. We'll calculate it h1. That is what we are doing. X1 w1 into plus x2 into w2 plus b1. Adding bias, we will get the value at h1. Now we will apply activation function on it. That is, we will get the output of h1. Out h1 equal to 1 by 1 plus e power minus h1. We will get this value. Okay, we have calculated for h1. Now in the same way, we will calculate for h2. So we will get the value, this one. In the same way, we will get the value h2. Okay, we got h1 and now h2. Now from this h1 and h2, we will calculate this y1 and y2. Okay, now calculating y1. Same, output of h1 into w5 plus output of h2 into w6 plus b2, we will get the y1, and we will calculate the output of y1 by applying activation function on it. That is 1 by 1 plus e power minus y1 equal to, we will get the value. Now we got the value of y1. Now in the same way, we will calculate the value of y2. Okay, so we will get in the same way y2 equal to this one value. Okay, now we got these two values, y1 value and y2 value. Now we got the outputs. Now our target values is these two values, y1 value and this one y2 value. These are matching with target values. Let's see. These are our target values, 0.01, 0.01. These are not matching. So we will calculate the error, how much error we got. So for calculating, formula is e total equal to sigma op into target minus output, our target values minus what we got, output values whole square. That is half into t1 minus output of y1 plus half into t2 minus output of y2 whole square. So this one is, this first part is called e1, error 1, error 2, because we got two values, no, output y1, y2. That's why error at y1, error at y2. This is so both. Now we will calculate those and we will get these values. Okay, you can do it, you can do the calculation and check it, you will get the values, this one, E total equal to this one. E1, E2 are error at Y1 and error at Y2. Okay. Now we got the error, total error. Now we calculate the error here. Now we will back propagate this error to update these weights W1, W2, W3, these all weights. Okay. For updating these weights, we will back propagate. Okay. Let's back propagate. Now backward pass. Okay. We'll update the weights. Now we'll calculate the error at W5. That is, we will calculate error at here, W5. For calculating error at W5, we'll differentiate it, partial differentiate it with the total error with what we want to do, W5. We'll partial differentiate it with, now we will got, we'll get the error at W5. So that we can update the weight W5. Okay. We need to partial differentiate this one, dou E total by dou W5. But you can see that in dou E total, there is no W5. So we cannot differentiate it to W5. So what we will do is, we will split this one, dou E total by dou W5, we will split into multiple terms so that we can calculate the value. So we will splitting into dou E total by dou of output at Y1 into dou output Y1 by dou Y1 into dou Y1 by dou W5. You can see, in output Y1 we can see that there is Y1. So we will calculate this one. We are calculating this one. Output Y1, this one. And again we will calculate this one and calculate this one. This all separately and multiply those values. Okay. Now we are calculating this one. Okay. Here. You can see. You can see. Here we are calculating dou E total by dou out 1. Differentiating this one with out Y1. Because there is a term out Y1 here. We are differentiating dou E total by this one. As we differentiate it and calculate the value, we will get this value. In the same way, we are doing this one. That is this thing. This thing we are doing here. In the same way, this one. Now we calculated three values. Okay. In the same way, dou Y1 by dou W5. Okay. Now this. Now we got this value, and this value we calculated here. Okay. These three values we have calculated. Now we multiply this one. Now we will get the total partial differentiation with W5. Errors partial differentiation with W5. So we will get this value. Okay. This is a change. What we have to change in W5. So we will update the W5 with this change. Okay. By subtracting this value, subtracting from W5, we will get the updated W5 value, weight of W5. So the for updating you need to use this formula W5 equal to W5 minus eta into this one partial differentiation dou E total by dou W5. What is eta? Is this eta is learning rate for training the network. We use learning rate. Learning rate can be any, you can take any value between 0 to 1. Okay. We calculate that one. We will place W5 0.4 minus eta is we have taken 0.5 into this one. What we got here value, this one. Now we got the updated W5 value. That is this one. We got updated W5 value. In the same way we get W6, W7, W5 for all these weights. So we will get W6. So we will get W6, W7, W5. We have got these four values. Okay. Now we got these values, we have updated this. Now we will update these weight values. Okay, we have back propagated till this. Now by updating this, we have back propagated till this. Now we have back propagated here up to here. Okay, see. Now at hidden layer, we are updating this one W1, W2, W3, W4 values. Okay, for updating W1 in the same way, partial differentiating the error with the total error with W1. So directly we can see that in E total we can see that there is no term W1. So we again split this one dou E total by dou W1 such that we can calculate the value. Okay, we are splitting into this one into three terms. Again in this we cannot calculate this one. We cannot differentiate dou E total by dou out H1. So again we are splitting this one into again two terms. And in this two sum, also same, we cannot differentiate this dou E1 by dou out H1 with dou out H1. So again we are splitting into these two. Again we are split in the same way. These also, this one also we cannot calculate. So this one also we are splitting. So here there are multiple splits. Okay, don't worry. If you see it slowly, you will understand. Okay. So from again we are multiple splitting, splitting them again and again until the term gets into calculatable way. Okay. So we have splitted this one up to here. Now here we can calculate. So we are calculating this value. Now calculated for this one, and we are calculating these all terms what we have got. Calculating this one and this one, this whatever we have splitted, we have calculated that one. Okay, now here also, here we have splitted this one. Now here this one we are calculating, here this one we are calculating, here. Okay, now this one we have calculated, this one. Now we got all these three values. For W1 we got all these three values. Now we will multiply this value. Now we multiplied and now we got the value of partial depression error with partial depression W1. We got this value. We got this value. This is a change in W1. So now we will update the W1. Okay. As we updated before, same. W1 equal to W1 minus eta into change this one. Dou E total by dou W1. So we will get the value, this one, updated W1 value. In the same way, we will calculate it for W2, W3 and W4. So, now we have updated the weights of W1, W2, W3, W4. Now, updated the weights, this one. So, from here, we have backpropagated here, updating these values. And from here, we have backpropagated here, updating these values. So, we have come to starting. So, we have backpropagated. Now, we have updated the W1 values. Now, we will again forward propagate and calculate these output values and check whether they are near to the target values. And again, we will calculate the error value here. And again, we backpropagate and again update the weights and again forward propagate. In this way, we go on doing this one until we get these outputs near to the target value, or the error at these outputs is minimized. What we calculated, this e total error, that is minimized. Until then, we'll go on doing this process. So this is what backpropagation with an example. Thank you.